whatever is present in around you is informant, and how we are able to fulfill our needs, we are able to fulfill our needs with the help of the natural resources. Now, what is this new term, natural resources? And that is only the heading of our chapter, natural resources. So natural resources can be living, can be non-living, but it is that which, you know, anything which we are getting from the nature, and that something is fulfilling our needs, that something is essential for us, that something we depend on for our daily life, for our food, for our survival. So all that we get from nature are natural resources. What's the meaning of resources? Resources means, you know, having something in abundance, and from there we are using. That is resource. That we have something in abundance, and from there we are removing and we are using it. So how can we define these two terms altogether? Natural resources. So what is natural resources? It is a living or non-living component. It is the living or non-living component What it is a living or non-living component used, which is used by us to fulfill or meet our needs. So how can we define natural resources? Anything which is useful for us, that is natural. It can be biotic and it can be abiotic. That can be living also and that can be non-living also. So all the natural things which we are utilizing, which we are getting from the nature to be alive, to fulfill our needs, are known as natural resources. You know, these natural resources can also be known as, the sign is of known, okay, K-N-O-W-N, also known as earth resources. This can also be known as earth resources. Now, why this natural resources? Why this natural resources can be known as earth resources? Because the natural resources are, like, from where we are getting that? Natural resources we are getting from the earth. And so the natural resources can also be known as earth resources. Now, what are the examples of the natural resources? The examples can be sun, air, water, plants, animals, soil, fuels, okay? Which kind of fuel? Fossil fuel I'm talking here, okay? Fossil fuel. All these are the examples of natural resources. So, what is the meaning of natural resources? Anything which can be living or non-living, but is found in nature and utilized by us for fulfilling our needs for our survival. That all is natural resources. You know, earth has provided everything to us, everything which can complete our needs. But you know, the problem is there, the problem arises when the greed is there, when we become greedy, when we start using the resources more than required, maybe due to greed or for more comfortable, then the problem arises. Now, what is happening? Just now I have, you know, discussed that no individual can survive without interaction. Every individual has to interact with the other members of the species. Yes, every individual has to interact with the members of the same as well as other species. Now there is no place to write. So no individual can survive alone. They have to, every individual has to interact with the member of the same species, another species, as well as with the environment. So everything is, you know, actually was in balance. But when the man came into existence, when the evolution of man, you know, man came into existence, from there the destruction, you know, started. From very beginning, or from the, you know, after just the evolution of the human beings started using fire. And the point where the fire was started, from that point only we are creating, we are you know, mixing certain unwanted particle in the air, that means pollution is being created. But it was balanced, because earth has got tendency to balance itself. But you know, now this balancing situation has also gone. Now that now earth is not in a situation to balance itself. So why it is happening? Like, what exactly man is doing, and why man is doing, and what man is doing, because of that the natural resources are all imbalanced situation has come. So man has become greedy, and or the comfort zone is increasing, or maybe the needs are increasing. So why all these things are coming? Because of the increase in population, Now the first point is increase in population. Now when we talk about the increase in population, that means what? The number of individuals are increasing. When the number of individuals are increasing, that means the more food is required, more land to live is required, more excreta will be produced, more air, more waste will be produced. Now why this increase in population is there? Now I am talking only about India now. So when we talk about India, children, lot of reasons are there. First of all, the people are not too much, like all people, all Indians are not educated. Now when the lack of education is there, they do not understand that that certain measures should be used so that this number of children can be decreased. And on the top of that, they consider particular class they consider that more children will give rise to, if more children are there, that means more hands are there to work. Some may consider that the boy child is very, very essential, and for that reason also the population keeps on increasing, you know. Some consider that children are the blessings of God, and so there is no use or there is no need to use any kind of measures to stop this. You know, because of all these reasons, the population is increasing day by day. And this increase in population has given rise to many problems which we are going to talk about. Like you can say pollution, the second one I am coming to, pollution. Now what is pollution? When unwanted things get mixed up in air, water or land, soil, then pollution occurs. Land pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, and even the sound, radioactive and other pollutions are also there. So pollution is exactly what? When some unwanted substance get mixed up in the pure form, and then that particular thing gets polluted. So why this pollution is increasing? Again, because the population is increasing, it's increasing the pollution also. Now, when this pollution is increasing, it's affecting the balance of the nature, it's disturbing the balance of the nature, it's disturbing the, you know, the natural resources. So this pollution is also the major cause. Now, third one, industrialization. Use of vehicles, urbanization, now industrialization, lots of industries can be seen for everything, for paper, for chalk, for plastic, for textile, you know, lots and lots of industry, rubber industry, lots of industries are there, and all these industries are doing what? Creating pollution. Population is also more, so more materials, more things are required, industrialization, and more pollution, again natural resources are affected in the negative way. What we are studying actually, we have started with the environment. Whatever is around us is our environment. What is natural resources? The things which occurs naturally and is utilized by us to fulfill our needs are natural resources. It can be living, it can be non-living, it can be biotic, I mean to say, or abiotic. So air, water, plants, animals, all these are natural resources. Now how we are harming natural resources? How natural resources, why that condition of imbalance has come on the surface of the earth? Because of the increase in the population, because of the increase in pollution, because of industrialization, because of more use of vehicles, because of urbanization. Now all these has, you know, because of all these reasons, the natural resources are the total condition has become worsened, you know, it has become worse. Now actually we have got different kinds of natural resources. For some kind of natural resources, like, you know, which are never going to get over, we don't have to worry. But then what is the problem? The natural resources which will get over one day, that is a real worry, isn't it? So now we'll talk about the classification of the natural resources. So the natural resources can be classified on the different basis. So we are talking about now classification of the natural resources. Now, when we talk about the classification of the natural resources, then how the classification is done? You know, if we do not talk about the natural resources, in general also, whenever we talk about classification, how things are classified. So things are always classified on the basis of their similarity, dissimilarity. So it can be like, you know, certain things on the basis of what the classification has been done or can be done. So here the natural resources can be classified in the on the basis of three. So I think this classification should be started from the, you know, I should rub and then I'll write. So we'll just discuss a little and then we'll start from the beginning. So the classification of natural resources, first of all, the classification is done on the basis of the, like, you know, whether like the nature, how they are in nature. Then the classification is also done on the basis of their availability. Are they available in very little amount, or are they available in, you know, abundant abundance? So how they are available, and they are also classified on the basis of the utilization, like who is utilizing, either only one nation is utilizing or the everybody is utilizing that. So now we are talking about what? We are talking about the classification of the natural resources. So please note this point and then we will come to the discussion of the classification of the natural resources. We were discussing about the classification of the natural resources. So classification of the natural resources. Now, so we are talking about now classification of the natural resources. So how it can be classified? It can be classified into different ways. So the first one, first of all, I'll talk about is on the basis of, you know, the distribution. How is it distributed? So first of all, we'll talk about the on the basis of the distribution. On the basis of distribution. On the basis of distribution, that means whether the natural resources are utilized in the particular country itself, are the natural resources, our particular natural resources are utilized in you know, few countries, or is it utilized by all the countries throughout the world? So when we talk about sun, which kind of natural resources is it? It is the kind, or the solar energy, if we talk about, it is utilized by each country. There is no bar on that, there is no limit on that, there is no tax on that. Air utilized by each one of us, even animals and plants, you include every living thing. So these kind of natural resources are, you know, in one category. There are certain resources which are found only in a particular region. So again, a variation is there. There are certain kinds of resources which are shared by the nations. Talk about rivers. Few rivers are shared by the countries, by the few countries. So in this way, on the basis of the distribution, it can be divided into three: national resources, now the second one is international resources, and the third one is multinational resources. Now, at the name itself suggests national resources. National resources means this one is which kind of resource which is utilized by only one country, which is available only in one country. So, utilized by only one nation. Example can be mineral in a particular place, few minerals, or few rivers even. Now, when we talk about multinational, now what is the meaning of multinational? More than one nation, that means shared by nations, by few nations. It is shared by few nations. An example can be few rivers, as now I told, rivers are shared between the countries. But when we talk about international resources, when we talk about international, the name itself is suggesting international, that means used by all the countries, used by the world or all the countries without any restriction. So which kind of resources will be here? Air, sunlight. Yes. So these kind of resources, you know, like what, how here the division is done. First of all, what we are talking, about the classification of the natural resources. Now classification means that division of the natural resources on the basis of different things. So first we are talking about the distribution on the basis of the distribution, how the particular natural resource is distributed. So if it is present in a particular country only, only one particular country is only utilizing that, so that is national resource. That means a particular country is only utilizing that. If it is multinational resource, that means more than one country is utilizing that, it is being shared among the countries. But when we talk about international resources, that means like all the countries are using this, it is being, you know, there is no bar, there is no limit, there is no restriction for such kind of natural resource, for the use of such kind of natural resource. So this is our first classification, and this classification is done on the basis of the distribution. Now we'll talk about the second classification. Second classification is done on the basis of the nature. So now when we talk about the nature of the classification, so how can we say this? Now here the classification is done on the basis of their nature, that whether the chemical, that means what we are doing here, the distribution is done on the basis of the nature. Like what is the nature of this particular natural resource? Now, and you know, like whether they are living, whether they are non-living, which kind of material do they have, inorganic material or organic material, or they have mixed kind of material, that means inorganic also and organic also. So on the basis of the nature, they can be divided into three. So this can be inorganic. Now this organic includes non-living thing. Now this one is including what? I will write here only so that we can discuss the third one. It includes non-living thing. So when it includes non-living thing, so what are the examples, what can be the examples over here? It can be air, it can be sunlight, yes, it can be water. Now when we talk about the second type in the chemical one only, so that can be organic. Now organic means the presence of the organic matter, the presence of the things which are, you know, like all living things will come under the category of organic. So the plants, animals, microorganisms, will come under this category. Now what if the natural resource has certain organic part also and certain inorganic part also, and that is the reason the third one is mixed. Now what is there in the mixed? Mixed, I will write example of the soil. Now soil children has got inorganic thing in that, but it has got humus also. And how humus is formed? By the decay of the organic matter, the humus is formed. And that is the reason the soil is classified, or soil comes under the category of the mixed one. That means it has got inorganic part also in that, and it has got organic part also in that. So first of all, the classification on the basis of the distribution, and then on the basis of the nature, on the basis of the nature, that which kind of nature the natural resource has, whether they are of inorganic nature, that means they have all non-living things in that, or whether they have got organic thing, that means organic material is there in that, that means the living part is there. So if both are not there, or both are present, I mean to say, if both are there, that means the inorganic part is also there and the organic part is also there, then the third one is the mixed nature. That means it will has the inorganic nature and organic. That means the best example I can put over here is soil, because inorganic part is also there, and as humus is also there. What is humus? Humus, because of humus only the soil become fertile. Yes, it is present in the top layer. And how it is formed? It is formed due to the decay of the organic matter. So when the decay of the organic matter takes place, the humus is formed, and when the humus is formed, the soil becomes fertile. That means it is the best part of the soil, and that is the reason it can be classified into the, it can be there in the category of the mixed nature. Now we'll move to the third one, and third one is on the basis of the abundance, or on the basis of the availability. Now, on the basis of the availability, or on the basis of the abundance. So now here we have learned about the two classification. First on the distribution, third on the the chemical nature. So as the place was not written, was not here, so I have not written resources. So you can write it, but the place is not there so much, because I need more place over here. So inorganic resources, and the third one, here I can write mixed resources. Now on the basis of the abundance, that means whether the particular natural resource is present in abundance, like there is no need for us to worry for that particular natural resource. The human use do not have any kind of effect on that natural resource, or do we need to worry about that natural resource, or this natural resource will get finished within few years, or there are certain kinds of resources which even get finished if the good care is taken, we can replenish that particular resource. What all these are? So this all is what, like that division on the basis of abundance and availability, that how classification is done here, that whether this particular resource is in huge amount, or this one is going to get over, this one is going to get finished, it will get or whether the resource can be replenished, can be maintained. So on the basis of this, the third division is there, that is abundance and availability. So here in this, first of all, natural resources can be classified into two. Exhaustible. Okay. Now, so on the basis of the abundance and availability, the natural resources can be divided into certain categories. So the first can be the first one, what I'm talking about now, natural resources on the basis of the abundance and availability. So on the basis of this, the natural resources can be divided into inexhaustible and exhaustible. It can be exhaustible. Now, what is the meaning of inexhaustible and what is the meaning of exhaustible? It's a very common word, and from the word itself, the whole definition can be understood. Now, what is the meaning of exhaust? Some many a times we say, I'm feeling totally exhausted, isn't it? That means I'm tired. That means I'm not in a condition to work further. That means unavailable, isn't it? So, inexhaustible means what? It is not going to be exhausted. This is inexhaustible. That is the which kind of natural resource, children? The natural resource which is not in a condition that will get over again and again. So, how can we define in it? First of all, it's very, very important to understand the meaning of inexhaustible and exhaustible. So, inexhaustible means what? These kind of resources or the resources which are present in an unlimited amount that are inexhaustible resources. Now, again, I have not written here resources because you know a lot of place get. So, here inexhaustible resources are which kind of resources? Which are present in an unlimited amount. I've not written here present, so present in I will write here present in. And so what is inexhaustible resources? Those resources which are present in an unlimited amount. That means there is no limit for such kind of resources. And you know, on the top of that, the human activity do not affect the amount of such kind of resources. That means the human activity do not reduce their quantity. So, which kind of these resources are that even when we are using in an unlimited way, then also this resource is not getting reduced. If we are using it continuously, you know, there is no limit, there is no restriction for such kind of resources. So, what can be the examples of such resources? Definitely, children, it can be sun. Again, the sun energy, the solar energy, the sun, you know what you can write in a different way, air. So, you know, this is not going to get over now. In few books, you know, even you will find that water is written here, that water is not going to get over. But mind it well, if we talk about potable water, if we talk about fresh water, we all know the level, the condition of water in our country. And you know, it's a matter of real concern that the amount of fresh water, the amount of potable water, or the amount of the water which we can use is reducing day by day. So, I have written water over here. I have written a water over here, but it does not mean the potable water. It is the normal water which is present in the oceans, the you know, the sea. It will never come to an end. That we all know, that water will never come to an end. It is there and it will be there. So, what we are talking about the third classification. We are talking about the third classification, and this classification is on the basis of the abundance and the availability. And in this, the natural resources can be classified first into inexhaustible and exhaustible one. Now, the exhaustible resources are which kind of resources? The resources which are not present in an unlimited amount. But before we start discussing more about exhaustible resources, let me tell you that the exhaustible resources are the one which is again divided into two, and this two are the renewable resources, and non-renewable resources. So, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Now, how can we define? First of all, we need to define exhaustible resources. So, what is the meaning of exhaustible resources? Just opposite to what we have written in inexhaustible resources. I have written that this is present in an unlimited amount. So, it is present. And the human activity can bring any kind of change in it. Yes, so are affected by human activities. So nothing much here. Whatever was there in inexhaustible, that means they are not present in a limited amount, they are present in an unlimited amount. And we all know sun, if we keep on using sun's energy daily, there is no limit to that. And it is not going to come to an end. And in the same way, the activity, that means our activity, is not going to affect this inexhaustible resources. But when we talk about the exhaustible resources, these kind of resources are like what, or which kind of resources comes under this category? Or what is the meaning of exhaustible resources? The resources which can come to an end, which can get over. Yes, because these are not present in an unlimited amount. These are present in a limited amount. And second thing, very important, that these are affected by human activities. That means human activity can bring any kind of changes in the exhaustible resources. Now, as I told earlier, that exhaustible resources, yes, this is the main one. The exhaustible resources can be divided into two, and that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Let me square up this one also so that one can understand. So, natural resources, first of all, inexhaustible. Now, exhaustible one, again into renewable and non-renewable. Yes? Now, renewable, as the name suggests, the renewable resources are the resources which can be renewed, which can be replenished. These can be replenished or renewed. Yes, these are the resources which can be replenished. This can be renewed, can be maintained, if used carefully. Can be maintained if used carefully. And third one is what? The third one is both biotic and abiotic comes under this. So it includes, there is no place children, so writing in short, include both. Which one? Biotic as well as abiotic. Now, what can be the example of this? Now, it is involving biotic also and abiotic. That means it includes living things also, it includes non-living things also, and the main important point is that it can be renewed, it can be replenished, it can be maintained, it can be available always if it is used properly. I could have written, you know, I should have written, but there is no place over here to write. So now, what are the examples over here, children? The plants, animals. Yes. So, and you know, even the soil comes under this category, because the formation of soil also, no, as I told in the beginning only, that it takes years and years for the formation of the top layer of the soil, for the formation of the good soil, or for the formation of the soil, it takes thousands and thousands of years. So if it is not replenished, if it is not maintained, if it is not renewed, or best thing is that if we do not take care of, if the soil is not taken care of, that, so what will happen? It will blow off. We won't be having a good soil. But if we take care of that, then we will always have good and fertile soil. Now, non-renewable resources. First of all, I'll begin with example only. The fossil fuels. The best example is fossil fuels. Fossil fuels means coal, petroleum, diesel. Now, you know, even if we try to maintain, even if we use it in very less amount, even if we you know, try to maintain, but these are the resources which will get over one day. One day finally these resources will get over. And the second thing, we are not in a condition, or we, this is not in our hand. No, we cannot replenish these kind of resources. We cannot, you know, create such kind of resources. We cannot make coal and petrol. That is the reason these kind of resources has to be used with great care. So example I have written here, fossil fuels, and the first point is, there is no place for them to write, can't be replenished, can't be renewed or replenished, as there is no place. I am writing in very very short. Now, second thing, this includes only abiotic, only abiotic. That means living things are not included in this, or living resources are not the part of the non-renewable resources. And the third is, you know, even if you try to maintain, it is finally going to get over one day. So third point, will finish, will finish one day, it's going to get over one day. So on the basis of this, you know, like, whether they can be replenished, whether they cannot be replenished, it's here. And the division, you all can see that how it is divided into different ways. So we have discussed here about the classification of the natural resources. If we discuss about the classification of natural resources, it can be divided on the different ways, you know, first of all on the basis of the distribution, that where, in which country or which area is it present. So national resources, that means it is present only in that particular country. Okay, international means it is, you know, present everywhere. or it is utilized by every country, each one of us, without any restriction, without any limitation. And third is multinational, which is multinational. Yes, multinational I can write. So multinational means it is shared by more than one country. Like shared, that means automatically between two or more countries. So it is shared between the countries. Like for example, few rivers which flows from two countries, and so definitely has to be, the water has to be shared by the two countries. Now when we talk about the chemical nature, you know, on the basis of the nature, so how it can be divided, it can be divided into like inorganic resources, organic resources and mixed resources. Inorganic resources includes only non-living thing, or non-living thing in the sense non-living resources I am talking about. So it can be air, water, soil. Now but why soil is, while soil I have not written over here, why soil is written in mixed, because it contains humus also, which comes from the organic part, which comes from the living, when the living part, okay, when the living organisms, when the plants, when the animals, they die, and the dead part of the plants and animals get converted into humus, it forms soil. And that is the reason the soil is written in the mixed resources, because it includes, yes, because it includes both living or organic and inorganic matter, and that is the reason it is kept in the separate category, that is mixed resources. And organic, the plants, animals and microorganisms comes under this category. Now this is the third one, abundance and availability. On the basis of the availability, or how much this particular resources, natural resource is present, on the basis of that, because the few resources are there which are present in very less amount, whereas the few resources are present in the an unlimited amount. So first of all, natural resources, inexhaustible means the resources which are present in an unlimited amount, exhaustible resources which are present in an limited amount. Now how much you can use, no, whatever amount you can you want to use, because the human activities or the human use, I will write here use, which will make it more clear. So human use do not reduce their quantity, because they are present in an unlimited amount. For example, sun energy, solar energy, or air and water. Water, I have clarified how water comes under this category. Now exhaustible, this one is present in the limited amount. And the human activity brings change in the amount of the exhaustible resources. Why? Because the exhaustible resources are again divisible, it can be divided into two categories, and that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those resources which can be renewed, which can be replenished, which can be, you know, if it is maintained, then we can have such kind of resources for whole of our life. For example, plants and animals. So, and even this includes both biotic and abiotic factor. That means the living part is also there, and the non-living part is also there. And when we talk about non-renewable resources, even if we use it in a scarce way, very carefully, we try to manage, but one day finally such kind of resources will come to an end, and that is the reason the fossil fuels are kept in this category, because you know, if it is not used properly, it will get over sooner, but if it is used properly, then also it is going to get over one day. And that is the reason the fossil fuels comes under the category of the non-renewable resources. Now the human activity is definitely going to affect non-renewable resources. That particular thing that particular resource which is overused will get you know, cleaned up, which will get will be, you know, will get finished very, very soon. So, and only abiotic, that means the non-living resources, are included in non-renewable resources. So this is what, you know, what we have discussed is the classification of the natural resources on three different ways. We have studied this. Now we'll move to the next topic. Please note this.